Yo, what is up? Welcome to a takeoff and landing tutorial for fixed wing aircraft. I've gone ahead to put some markers or rather indicators for your practice sake. I generally wouldn't do this on a normal basis, but for starters, I think an indicator is important. You can have for this it's speed indicators. You can put distance indicator if you want to. Just a simple dot which you can find from your markers, which is your F6, or you can click on this this icon, then go to icons, anything really. You can put drawn or your standard military. You can put just a dot or maybe a some sort of a marker, and as long as it's an indicator for you to know that you are about to approach the runway. And maybe you can put, I don't know, maybe a speed indicator and then slash distance from runway. And then right now, I'm gonna put in your character, blank soldier, one here. As for plane, you can use any plane, just practice with it. I'm just gonna use a F-14. This is I think, yeah, Fire Wheels F-14. Zero. You have this. At the same time, if you are worried about crashing, okay, with regards to pylons, right? I don't think Arma has a, I don't really know. But I'm not sure if like your GPUs and all that would contribute to how fast your plane can take off, stuff like that. Might have some effect to it, but I can't feel the difference. So once again, damage. It's very important. If you want to crash, you're gonna crash a lot. Then disable the damage model, damage itself. If you want a bit of challenge, then just leave it as it is. So right now, I'm just gonna drag my guy in, and yeah, pretty much. Let's start. And before that, there is a option for you to, if you're using ACE, for those out there using ACE, under settings, add-on options, you can go to, I think GeForce or something like that. Along the line, you can go check it out. But this is not needed for this tutorial. You can turn on and off the GeForce, but then again, like I said, not necessary for this one. So let's just start. Regardless to any aircraft you're using, I would usually like to put my map on the right side of my screen, which is like that. To use this, you need to hit your left or right square bracket key, depending on which side you want it to be. If you want it on the left, you hit the left square bracket. If you're on the right, then the corresponding right bracket. You can check your key binding if you need to. Right, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, check your map once again. Indicators, very important. Sorry, it's a bit loud right now. Once again, indicators are very important. You can customize it however you like, however you want, as long as it's gonna tell you how far are you away from the airstrip. Then that's fine. Mine's right now is just speed indicator. Yeah, you can do anything. Then let's taxi the runway. You will want to keep your speed between less than 40, 40, 30, 30, 40, around there. You can align yourself if you want. Not really needed. So before you take off, I think take a deep breath. I don't know. Next thing to do, the actual step one, control, and then you scroll down. That would activate your flaps. I generally will go full flaps. Then afterwards, I don't know. You do your pre-flight checks if you need. If you can go third-person camera, look around. Flaps test. Alright, it's fine if you're satisfied. Full power. Wait for it to hit 250 and then you're just gonna pull up slowly. Don't yank it, but just gradually pull up. Alright, once you are above, I think 50 meters would be nice. Gear up, press G. Or whichever binding yours, mine's G. Then flaps up, so it's the opposite, so it's control, and then the opposite direction, which is scroll upwards. Okay, I'm just gonna fly around. Once you are comfortable flying around, playing with the plane, I'm only flying with a mouse, so hence my left hand is free. Left hand free, I'm controlling the mouse only for now. Yeah. Your pitch, yaw, and stuff like that. Once you're satisfied, go back to your map. I would advise that is, go back to your map, shift left click on your start point, your entry point. You can do it somewhere here if you want to. I'll do it at the edge of it. And then make your way there. It's 10.4 clicks out. At this point, you would, if you're clear and there's no one shooting at you, you are confident that, alright, fine, if I'm going to fly at a very slow speed, I won't get shot down. What you would like to do is to reduce your speed as much as possible. That's what I indicated. You can do 600 or something, doesn't matter. I would do 500 for starters. Alright. So once again, I'm hitting, I'm pressing a whole X to slow myself down. Okay. You do not need to strictly follow 500 kilometers per hour, but it's a nice indicator. I'll slow myself further. Coming at a 400, so we'll slow it. If you think you're off course, adjust slightly by tilting your plane left or right, depending on how your course correction would be. Okay, past the second marker, you will see the runway down there. I'm slightly off course, I'm going to tilt to the left, downwards a little bit. At this point, I would want to be at 300 meters. Both flaps down. Control, then scroll down. Gear down. You would want to land at around 250. Same as your takeoff speed. If it's easier for you to remember. But generally, 250, 260, 70 or so. That would be nice. If you want, make sure your gear are down, your angle of entry is not too steep. So right now what I'll do is pull up a little bit. Alright, slow it down. Yeah, I'm off by way a lot, but then again, I know this plane, I know you can stop real quick. So I'm fine. Takes a lot of practice, I'm not the best, once again. Alright, so that's day landing done. Right now, off to night landing, which is a bit challenging. Once again, we'll do the same thing with the markers, but just at night. Alright, let's go. Alright, so for night takeoff is generally the same as your daytime. What you do, engine on. Same thing, I want to adjust my map to the right side of my screen. Alright, once you are somewhat aligned, you do not have to be straight. As long as you can take off properly, safely, that's fine. Once again, full flaps down. Full power. Once it reaches around 250, you can slowly pull off, pull up. Do not, once again, reminder, do not yank the plane, but just push your mouse slightly upwards. You're up. 50 meters, gear up. Lights off. Flaps up. And you're off. Okay, we are landing your plane right now. You will do same method. Press M and then you shift left click on the start marker. Make your way to the start marker and do the same process. Alright, I'm just gonna do the same thing. Trust your marker first. You can worry about things like I don't know, flight path, any variations in it, but then again, the fundamentals are the same. Just trust your marker. Okay, you have a heads-up display, use it. Trust the numbers, your height, your altitude number, your speed, and then the marker that you have created. Since you will most likely be playing alone, for this one. It's just training, so don't worry about it. And again, tilt left and right to adjust yourself, align yourself with the indicator. The good thing about night landing is that you can see your runway if you're using the vanilla maps. Some maps are, they don't really have a runway marker, so you have to trust your marker. You have to draw your own if you have to in the server also. I will want to drop to about 200. Alright, my gear, my full flaps. If you need light, put light. I don't think it makes a difference. Slow down your plane. Use Q and E if you have to again. Then again, tilt. You'll align yourself. Okay, I'm going to shut off the engine. 0%. Okay, angle of approach. Slow it down, slow it down. And we're done. Nailed it. Continue holding X for your brakes until you have come to a halt. And they're done. That's pretty much it. You can taxi back to hangar or whatever, as indicated if you are in the server. But yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. Like and share if you have enjoyed it or if you have learned something. And that, once again, if you think I'm doing something wrong, do let me know in the comment down below. And with that, I'll see you in the next video. See ya!